Ladies and gentlemen, we are live with Anoop Desai, Anoop Dog from American Idol season, what was it, eight?
Eight,
yeah. Eight, yay,
eight.
Bravo, fantastic.
We are so excited to have you.
Oh, thanks. No, it's really great to be here. I was tweeting on the way over here that I was going to be here today, so I'm excited.
Well, it's a special tweet for us that you showed up.
We need to be Twitter buddies.
Yeah.
Twitter buddies.
Co-followers?
Absolutely. Yeah. If you follow me, I'll follow you.
You know what? I'll do it right now.
Okay, perfect. Look at that. Me too.
Cool.
If you're on Twitter or if you're on Ustream, you can write back to it. Oh, look, we already have people.
What are they saying?
They say, hey, y'all. Hi, Anoop. Anoop.
Hey.
That's so far what we've gotten. So
everyone's
going to join in the conversation. Now, you're here. My first question whenever an artist comes in is, wait a minute, where's the concert and why don't I have tickets? But that's not the case. You're just basically here to see us and say hi?
Yeah, to say hi. And we'll talk to y'all about my new single. So hopefully there will be a concert in the next couple weeks or month or whatever. But yeah, my album All Is Fair came out about 2 months ago.
Yeah.
And right now we're about to release the title track, which is the single, also called All Is Fair, and Crazy Love in parentheses. And yeah, just want to get the word out about that, and you know, hopefully all your listeners will be hearing it soon.
And we'll buy tickets and go.
Exactly.
I'm not buying tickets. I'm getting them from promotions.
I mean,
I am buying tickets because I never take anything free from anywhere.
Right.
No.
Let me ask you a question, though, because I'm looking at your album cover,
mm-hmm.
and you look very serious and despondent. And you're looking down like you're heartbroken.
He looks hot.
You're in some kind of intense thought, but typically, but here you're like smiling and giggly and happy.
Well, we wanted it to be the album cover is actually sort of a throwback to some of the old like Marvin Gaye covers and stuff.
Gotcha.
Like that. So I mean, we wanted it to be, you know, in that sort of smoky Marvin Gaye type, you know, feel. But no, I mean, you know, if you listen to the music, it captures, I think, a whole range of emotions. I mean, the album is called All Is Fair because, you know, I wrote most of the songs about experiences I've had in love and war, you know, and sort of different sides of that same
Which
coin.
War were you fighting?
Oh my gosh. numerous wars with numerous girls.
Now, American Idol is one of those things that you just really don't understand. You go, you try out, you think it'll be fun, but you don't understand how life-changing it is until you get to where you were.
Yeah, yeah, and you know, it really is what you do with it afterwards. I mean, you know, I was lucky enough to come in sixth, and that was great for me, but you know, I always knew that was going to be the beginning, and then you go on the tour and everything, and I always had it in my mind that when I got off the tour, this is what I was going to do.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You know, I was going to make the most out of it. So it is life-changing, and it's a crash course, it's boot camp, you know, whatever you want to call it, but you know, at the end of it, you're better, you know, you're much better off for the wear.
What's it like when you go down the street and people are like, "Oh my gosh, it's Anoop!"
I mean, it's gratifying. It's really cool. And you know, I would say the day that people stop doing that, that's when I know that I've done something wrong. You
mm-hmm.
know, because the goal is to keep that up. You know, to build on what I've been given. So I always appreciate it whenever you know someone comes up to me and either says, you know, I enjoyed you on the show or I enjoy your music now. It's great.
I tell my wife the same thing. Like we were at California Pizza Kitchen the other day, and three pairs of panties landed on our table.
Right, and it's
oh
like,
oh my gosh!
I said to my wife, she goes, "Ew, I'm eating," and I said, "Hey, the day that stops, you know, you're not going to be eating at these swanky California Pizza Kitchens anymore."
Right.
Spare me, Mark.
Anyway, I feel you. I feel your pain, Anoop. But now you had a great season too, because not only was it there you, who now has an album out, but that Goki character,
Danny, was there.
Yeah, with the glasses.
Yep.
I noticed you have glasses on.
I do have glasses.
That's a good like Buddy Holly cut. That looks very in.
It makes you look smart, you. But you already are smart. So
I gotta.
Anna, maybe you should get some glasses.
I have glasses. I just wear them.
And
why
then,
not?
Because they're from ninth grade. So
oh, okay. There you go. There you go.
Reason. And then you had the Adam Lambert guy.
That guy.
Are you in touch with him at
I
all?
I am. No, we're all actually in touch.
Really?
Yeah. I mean, because, and I guess, I don't know, it might have been weird, which we found out later, but our season actually got along very well. I'm not sure if that was the case with every season or, you know, has been in the past, but we got along really, really well. So we all, you know, at least keep up with each other, know what we're doing. And when we're in the same town, we get together, and it's just
Adam ever give you like makeup tips and stuff
or hair tips?
Yeah.
No. I was We made fun of each other a lot. I will say that.
You
just
did?
Like, I mean, just like poking fun. You know, you live with this group of people for the better part of a year, you know. So you get to be sort of like brothers. And all the guys, of course, just hung out all the time. And, you know, we were in the same dressing room on tour and everything. So I spent pretty much every waking moment for, you know, 8 months with these people. So you get to... You get that sort of credibility to go after him every once in a while.
Well, I think if you're really close with somebody, that means you can like make fun and joke around.
Oh, yeah, no, for
like,
sure.
Mark and I make fun of each other all the time. What?
That doesn't prove your point at all.
No, but we're close.
Oh, right, yeah, geographically.
Right. Oh, God.
Y'all
are both from, or at least spent time in North Carolina.
You know, here's an interesting fact. I mean, interesting just to the three of us.
Right.
Nobody else is going to care
about
it.
No one else is going to care about it whatsoever.
Anna and I worked for the same radio station in Raleigh, G105.
Did y'all work for G105?
Uh-huh,
we did, but at different times.
Okay.
I was there like 5 years before she was, and now we're both here, and you're here too.
And now I'm here.
And you still live in Chapel Hill. We were talking about that.
Yeah, and G105 is a station that I've literally been listening to.
Since
I remember
you're a
listening
kid.
To, like, on the first day of kindergarten.
Yeah.
I remember listening to G105.
I think that's when I was there, actually.
Probably.
I remember a little Anoop going off the class and his parents letting him go. Anoop Desai, of course, let me plug the album for you once again. You have a website, which is anoopdesai.com.
That's it.
The AnoopDesai. All is Fair is the album. All is Fair is also the single. And you can follow him on Twitter. There's all sorts of stuff going on there. Season 8 of American Idol was also good because you were the last season to escape the Ellen DeGeneres as a judge.
That's right.
I mean, that way. Have you been watching this, Pat? Did you watch this past season?
I watched. To be honest with you, I always, like, when I watch, I normally skip over the judges' comments because those, like, those give me a sick feeling in
really?
The pit of my stomach. So, always.
Mm. Well, okay. Well, you're lucky that you fast-forwarded Ellen DeGeneres because she is no Paula Abdul, man.
Well, you know, she's... Well... I think she's a very... like the reason that I like Ellen on the show, and at least the idea of Ellen on the show, is because, you know, she has that pressure that we have every time, you know, you get up in front of that audience. You know, she has a show that's watched by millions of people, and she has to deliver each and every day. And so she, you know, she knows what she empathizes.
Yes, but unfortunately for us, America can't vote her off at the end of every show.
Oh, stop it. You're mean.
I'm just saying.
What do you think about, yeah, you're acting like Simon right now. Speaking of, what do you think about him leaving?
It's going to be a transition period for sure for the show. I mean, he's a really, really good guy, actually. And so I'm sad to see him not be a part of the show anymore. But you know, he's going to do great things, and Idol is always going to be Idol, I think. For the simple fact of the matter, you know, a lot of people are like, oh, it's not doing as well as it used to do, but it's still getting 25 million viewers, you know, every single time it goes on the air. So it's not, you know, it's not about to get canceled or anything.
I know, you lose 50% of your audience, but when you have 20 times as many viewers as the next show,
exactly.
you're still doing fine.
Exactly.
What's next for you then? So you've got this album out, and now you're doing this big publicity tour.
Yeah.
You're here. I mean, what do you do after coming to WAPE?
Just listen to a lot of Skynyrd, pretty much.
Awesome! I love that!
That's what I plan on doing, at least. I got the playlist all synced up and everything. We're going to get back in the car and just listen to Curtis Lowe or something.
There's,
I don't know.
There's a lot of it around here. You got to head out to Jack's Beach. You got to go to the Freebird.
I really want to. I mean, I've never been to Jacksonville before, but... Okay, so when I was in college, I was an American studies major, and like, so cultural studies pretty much, and my point of emphasis was on the South, and Southern music in particular, and so I actually wrote like a 45-page paper on Skynyrd once.
Wow,
you did?
That's so cool!
A 45-page paper on
Leonard Skynyrd. It was a term paper for the Southern music class, and I focused on Skynyrd.
Get drunk, play music.
I had a shirt that said Skynyrd, but that's about it.
I'm looking to see what's coming up at the Freebird Live. How long are you in town?
Actually just for a couple hours.
Oh well.
Oh, boo.
So, never mind.
So I guess not.
If you were here on Saturday, you could see Colonel Bruce Hampton and the Quark Alliance.
I'd go.
I wonder how many pages you could write a paper
Where
on.
Are you going from here?
We are going to Orlando.
O-Town. Okay.
Perfect.
Cool.
Well, we are very excited and stoked. Chris Allen, do you still talk to him too?
Yeah, we were randomly in Atlanta at the same time a couple weeks ago, so we had dinner.
Well, listen, all of you and your American Idol fans, we're so glad. One of my favorite seasons was season 8. I think hands down, the cast of season 8 was probably the best American Idol cast we've ever seen. The tour was great, even though you skipped Jacksonville. So we had to drive.
Yeah, what's up with that?
I know it's not your fault.
Not my choice. We also we skipped weird cities. Like, we skipped Houston.
Houston?
It's like, well, you would think that
That doesn't make
sense. You know,
sense.
You'd go to Houston and Jacksonville.
A lot of people in Houston.
Right. Yeah. And I mean, you know, but whatever.
Well, listen, next time, when you're doing your own tour, when you're headlining,
yes.
We want to make sure that you have a stop here in Jacksonville. We'll all buy tickets.
Thank you so.
I'll get them from the promotions department.
You pick them up from the promotions department.
And buy them.
Thank you.
Yeah. See?
That's true.
Raleigh,
that's love.
Sticking together here. Raleigh, North Kakalaki. There you go.
Okay. All Is Fair, the title of the album and the single from Anoop to Psy. You can get it anywhere. Buy it today. Anoop, thank you so much for being here.
Thank y'all. I hope to be down here soon.
Anoop to Psy, everybody. Yay.